One of the biggest steps in human evolution is exactly when our species started to walk upright on two legs. That one change gave us everything that we've ever made and done, from Minecraft to marshmallows. The oldest possible evidence for our ancestors walking upright comes from a skull found in Chad. Despite being cracked and weathered by the elements, this fossil took the world by storm when it was discovered because of its age and where it was found. But it turned out that the people who found it had another critical fossil from this individual that could tell us even more about our shift upright. And they hid it from the scientific community for decades. So, the fossil or fossils we're going to talk about today belong to a species now known as Sahelanthropus chadensis. And right from the get-go, things were weird with this guy. Not just the fossil itself, but the circumstances around how it was found. The skull was discovered in 2001 in Chad. Credit for the find goes to Michel Brunet, a researcher working at a university in France. And yes, that awkward phrasing was intentional. See, Brunet wasn't the person who dug the fossil up, or even the first to see it at all. The actual discoverer was a geographer named Alain Beauvelin, who was doing some groundwork for future excavations. But Brunet was the director of the research project, and because of how academic publishing generally works, the honor of telling the world about the find went to him. It's kind of like how we credit Steve Jobs as the inventor of the iPhone, even though lots of other engineers and tech people were the ones to actually, like, make the first phones. So Brunet published his paper on the new fossil in 2002. The specimen, as described in the paper, consisted of a nearly complete cranium, as well as some fragments of teeth and jawbones. Alongside this fossil individual, which was nicknamed Toumaï, the researchers also dug up a collection of other miscellaneous bones from other animals living alongside Toumaï. After examining the skull, Brunet announced that it represented a brand new hominin species. Hominins are the group that includes modern humans and all of our relatives after we split from chimpanzees. He determined that this skull was on our side of the family tree based on some key features. It had a tucked-in face rather than a projecting muzzle like a chimp. It lacked the large, self-sharpening canine teeth that many other primates have, but our ancestors lack. And the most crucial piece of evidence was the location of the foramen magnum. This is the hole in the base of the skull where the spinal cord meets up with your brain. For animals that walk around on all fours, this hole is towards the back of the skull. And in humans and other upright things, it's at the bottom, so we can look forward without doing too much neck bending. According to Brunet, the foramen was right underneath the skull, meaning that Toumaï was bipedal, which would be a slam dunk for the skull belonging to a hominin. And the skull belonging to a hominin would be kind of a big deal. The fossil dated back to roughly 6 or 7 million years ago, which would make it one of the oldest known hominin fossils even to this day. What's more, the fact that it was found in Chad was also intriguing since, while Chad is still in Africa, it's fairly far away from the East African Rift countries where previous hominins have been found. The vast majority of our ancestors' fossils came from places like Kenya, Tanzania, Ethiopia, and South Africa. So having a really early ancestor all the way across the African continent was a huge deal. And right away, researchers started talking about how unbelievable it was to find a hominin this old and in this location. As in, they didn't believe it. Now, some pushback after a big find is normal, of course. Science thrives on disagreement because that inspires new research and, hopefully, consensus findings. But things quickly started going beyond the normal arble-garble. For one thing, one of the people who seemed to have a bone to pick was actually Beauvelin, the guy who, you will remember, actually dug up the fossil in the first place. Beauvelin and Brunet had reportedly been feuding with each other for years, despite being co-workers for a lot of that time. Beauvelin would go on to publish a paper arguing that a tooth assigned to Sahelanthropus was misidentified and put into the skull in the wrong place, a left molar on the right side. A relatively minor error, but an embarrassing one, since it implies that Brunet doesn't know how to tell teeth apart. But this paper ended up catching Beauvallon a lot of flack, because most other researchers agreed with Brunet's assessment. The ensuing academic chaos was so bad that the reviewer of Beauvallon's paper wrote to Brunet to apologize. And that's just the drama around the fossil that the public knew about. The real story is about the fossils that we didn't. Remember how we said that Sahelanthropus got attention because it was the oldest known fossil hominin proposed to walk upright, thanks to those clues from the skull, like the foramen magnum? Well, the foramen magnum is good, but the best way to tell how something walked is probably more by looking at the legs, especially the femur. Compared to other apes, our femurs angle inwards so that our knees are directly underneath our center of gravity. Our femurs are also really long. Seriously, we're kind of the primate equivalent of giraffes. And our hip muscles connect relatively far down and far back on the bone, which gives us good leverage for walking. In apes, the muscle attachment point is further up, which is better for climbing. In short, the bipedal human femur is pretty distinct and pretty specialized. And all of this means Toumaï's femur would have been super valuable for helping nail down whether it truly walked upright. Unfortunately for researchers, they didn't have any. But a few researchers knew differently. There was a femur that had been found with the Toumaï skull, and Brunet was covering it up. As reported by Scott Sayer in The Guardian in 2004, two researchers in Brunet's lab both saw this femur in the collection of fossils from the Toumaï excavation. Aude Bergeret was a master's student at the time and was working on a project where she needed to examine several fossils from Chad, including from the Sahelanthropus site. She'd been told to cut open this odd-looking leg bone to look at any sediments found inside. Something about this bone made her pause. She may have suspected that this bone was special or just wanted advice on how best to cut into it to get as much information as possible. But her immediate advisor and Brunet were both away doing fieldwork and couldn't be reached. So Bergeret contacted her university's head of the Department of Geosciences, a researcher named Roberto Macchiarelli, for advice. When Macchiarelli saw the bone, he recognized it as a primate femur. What's more, he knew from the number that it was given that it had been collected from the same site as Sahelanthropus, which means it was pretty likely to be Sahelanthropus's leg bone. Macchiarelli, seeming to recognize its potential importance, told Bergeret not to cut into this bone and to do a close study of it instead. If he was right, they may have found critical evidence about Sahelanthropus that the other researchers had missed back in 2001. And to be clear, it's totally possible that Brunet just didn't happen to recognize this femur among all the other fossils that were picked up that day. It happens. However, once Brunet got back from his trip and heard what the two had done, he was reportedly furious at the both of them. Neither Bergeret nor Macchiarelli were permitted by Brunet to publish any research on this femur or even look at it again. Now, you might speculate that this was because he had his own plans to write up a paper about the femur, since a femur from a hominin this old would be a really big deal. But if that was the case, you'd think he'd been grateful that it wasn't cut into pieces. So his reaction to this whole thing seemed strange, even at the time. Years went by, and Brunet didn't publish anything about the bone. And Macchiarelli grew more and more frustrated by what seemed to him to not just be an oversight, but a cover-up. What could that bone say that was so damaging? Meanwhile, publishing on Sahelanthropus continued, not all of it flattering. Beauvallon did not stop critiquing Brunet's work. In 2009, for instance, he argued that the fossils were not what scientists call in situ, meaning they weren't in the exact positions they had been in when they were fossilized and had been moved, either by erosion or by human activity. His evidence included the weathering of the skull, which made it look like it had at one point been exposed to the desert sun and wind and then reburied. This wouldn't necessarily mean that Toumaï wasn't a hominin, but it would mean that we can't be as sure of its actual age. It could be far younger than 6 million years old, which would mean it no longer represented that pivotal early period after the split between our lineage and the chimpanzee line. Now, to be clear, most people still accept that Toumaï is as old as the original author said, so this paper didn't really change many hearts or minds. However, it did open the door for an entirely different challenge to Brunet's legacy. Later that year, a paleoanthropologist named John Hawks posted photos of Toumaï's missing femur to his blog, before the bone had been formally described by any of the researchers associated with the species. He had gotten the photos from Bergeret, the student who'd studied the femur back in Brunet's lab. Once again, publishing these photos to the world for the first time is a huge break of norms in paleoanthropology. Brunet had never given his blessing for the publication of the photos, and he was the one who had first rights over studying anything from Toumaï's excavation. But Hawks argued that while these particular photos were new, posting them was fair game, because this wasn't technically the first time the femur had appeared in print. See, the femur is visible in photos that were included in Beauvais-Lon's 2009 paper, meaning that Beauvais-Lon had broken the precedent, not Hawks. At this point, the existence of the femur was public knowledge, but there still weren't any studies about it, and Machiarelli was not happy about it. Eventually, Brunet's university and Machiarelli agreed that as long as the university got first dibs, they'd publish something about the femur. But in 2020, Machiarelli went back on his word and published a full formal description of the fossil that he had not seen since 2004 and had only pictures of and had promised not to publish anything about. Machiarelli's paper pulled no punches. He argued that the curve and the shape of the bone suggested that Toumaï walked on all fours, not bipedally, as Brunet still argued. That said, their analysis was based solely on photos and sketches, so they weren't exactly playing with a full hand or leg. 2 years later, in 2022, Brunet's former lab published their description of the femur as well as two new forearm bones. By this point, Brunet had kind of stepped back as a researcher, so his old lab took up the mantle. Their analysis was much more thorough since they, you know, had the actual bones to study and not just pictures. For instance, they spotted a feature known as the linea aspera, which is a line on the back of the femur where your butt and hip muscles connect to the bone. Having a linea aspera suggests that those muscles are strong and flexible, which you only need if you're walking on two legs, not four. Analysis of virtual cross-sections of the bone suggests it was built to take the kind of compressive, twisty forces you'd get if you were placing your entire weight on the leg. Plus, while Machiarelli said the shape of the bone wasn't right for a biped, the 2022 team disagreed. And I kind of want to give them that one since they had the actual bone to look at. All in all, they argued this was the femur of a bipedal hominin. As it stands today, new paleoanthropology papers generally seem to lean toward placing Sahelanthropus as a hominin, even though there's still debate about exactly how much time it spent on 2 feet. So that's where we are. A skull that captured the paleoanthropological world's attention, a femur that was hidden away for nearly 20 years by possessive researchers, and a field of ethical norms shattered. Deciphering the history of human evolution is a grand task, one that can capture the world's attention. But when the stakes are that high, perhaps it's not surprising that egos can get involved. It seems that after all this drama, Sahelanthropus still has one bipedal leg to stand on. For now, anyway.